Everyone, I want to thank you for your help. All right, commencing operation. Generating wormhole.
We want to rethink this, now's the time.
You wait until now to say that?
Can you two lovebirds save it for later?
Same for you and your lechers, old man. Okay, everybody ready?
Here it comes!
Protected. wave incoming. We're past the halfway point with the trap. Hang in there, Captain. Activating the defense support ability that Chris prepared for us. Protected.
Another enemy attack.
The trap process is nearly complete.
You can do this, Captain.
Activating the defense support ability that Chris prepared for.
final battle. Let's go.
Dread dust infection has surpassed 70%. I can no longer acquire the target by myself.
Captain, you'll have to do it for us.
Aim for where its shell is thinnest. That's where it's the weakest.
The railgun takes some time to reload.
Everyone, listen up. There is only one way to defeat the Lord of Dust. After running an analysis on the phenomenon we've witnessed just now, one significant problem has come to light.
The Dread Dust didn't begin their existence as organic life. Therefore, they have no concept of death. They began as nanomachines. As long as they have no concept of their own death, they will not cease to function. This appears to be the reason why it has been impossible to destroy them.
I'm just gonna ask you point blank. Is there really a way to beat this thing?
Yes, but before I elaborate, please listen to this.
We don't have time for this shit.
We don't have time for this shit. I can almost hear Reeve when this message starts. I can empathize, because I'm sure you're still in the middle of the battle. But I need you to listen to me. This really will be my final message to you. Consider it my last will and testament. First of all, Reeve, before I continue, I have to apologize to you.
We really don't have time for this. Captain, try hitting it with the railgun again. We can't...
I let you down. I spent 30 years trying, but in the end, I couldn't get you out of that place. Please, please forgive me.
Let me down? No. You're Chris?
I remember it like it was yesterday. That day, 30 years ago. When the captain got me to the wormhole above base camp, and I made it home. But I couldn't have expected what happened next. Instead of going back to 1980, I ended up in Philadelphia in 1943, in the skies above the USS Eldridge. Wardenclyffe section hadn't been around that long, and this was their first full-blown test of the wormhole teleportation. And so I, descending from the skies, became the greatest achievement of the Philadelphia experiment. For the next several years, I was the section's little plaything. But over time, I rose to the rank of researcher and gained more influence in the section. And what supported my research was the device that you, Reeve, gave to me. I quickly became one of the leading scientists in my field. But most of my work was simply me recreating what I'd seen on the device. It wasn't because I was smarter than anyone else. I discovered absolutely nothing. But I was fine with that. I wasn't after fame or fortune. I wanted to atone for what I had done to all of you. What I had done to the world. Thus, the gates of hell were flung open. Though my own personal hell wasn't D-Day, but back here, the reality. For 30 years, I have sacrificed everything to prepare. All these preparations for this one fleeting moment. When you hear this, the Lord of Dust will likely have already opened his door to the past. Captain, it's all up to you and the others. History, the survival of mankind depends on whether or not you can pull this off. I'm counting on you, heroes without names. The future is in your hands.
That is Good Luck's final message.
Chris.
Virgil, tell me something. How do we destroy this thing?
There is only one way.
I must become one with the Lord of Dust and reveal the concept of death to all Dread Dust.
Once this has happened, fire the railgun at the Lord of Dust and me.
Seth, a human being, understood death. The Dread Dust that infected him. Because it was so dependent on the properties of its host, when Seth's body was destroyed, so was the dust within him. I will do the same thing to the Lord of Dust.
But Virgil, if you do that, you'll...
I am ready for that.
Do you even understand what death is?
At the very least, I have developed my own interpretation of it.
I have spent a long time with the Karen Corps, the Captain, and all of you. Journeyed with you, fought alongside you. I have realized that your existence is fragile and fleeting. And while the Dread Dust was eating away at me, I became aware of a concept. An aversion to my existence coming to an end. This could even be called fear. Existence is finite. Life is precious. And death is sorrowful. Captain, is my understanding correct? Then I think we have a plan. This truly will be the final battle. The meaning of life. The reason for death. The value of existence. I will teach these to the dust. I will teach them everything I learned having to survive in this world with all of you. I am ready to do this.
We leave the rest of the work to you.
There is no more time.
Goodbye, everyone.
I designated myself as the target. You must do the rest. I truly enjoyed the time we spent together.
Get through it together. You can do this, Captain.
soul from the bottom of my heart. Force of resolve.
Back to camp. Let's go home.
Operational support program, Virgil 89, reboot complete. Revealing the concept of death to the Lord of Dust was a success. However, I myself survived the process. Though the destructive power of the railgun was extraordinary, as you can see, it didn't destroy me. It appears my body was built with the same materials used to construct nuclear blast shelters. According to my analysis, it was designed this way in case of nuclear war. This was quite a surprise. Also, the dread dust that had infected us has ceased functioning. As a result, my personalities have merged into one. So I should be able to provide you with firmer guidance from here on. Getting home may turn out to be a long paddle, but as they say, Captain, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
I made a miscalculation.
Whatever it was, I have to report this to the section.
This isn't the first time you've crossed the line with your initiatives. They're going to come down on you hard, I imagine. Better prepare yourself.
Fine by me. History was changed. Thank you, Heroes Without Names. And thank you, Captain. But this isn't the end. Now it's my turn to fight. I will get you all out of that place. And then I continue to keep watch. To ensure that technology run amok cannot destroy the world again. This time, we will build a better future.
プレイステーション。